Hey guys. So in this video, we are going to discuss about NiFi basic terminologies. So whenever I go through next videos, you will be able to understand what I'm trying to say. Okay, and in terms of technical jargons, we'll be on the same page. So before we begin into that, just wanted to let you know that I'm going to continue this environment, which we installed on Linux machine. So yeah, so going forward, I'm just going to give you all the examples using this in NiFi instance. And for explaining the terminologies, I'm going to take reference of Apache NiFi user guide. So if you just scroll down in the NiFi user guide, you will be seeing data common terminologies such as data flow manager. So a data flow manager is someone who's basically going to create all these processes or going to develop all these data flows, and that guy is going to have permission to add or remove or modify the component of NiFi data flow. Okay, so during our tutorials, we are pretty much going to act like a data flow managers. The next one is flow file. So flow file is anything which is single piece of data in NiFi. So if you remember, in our previous video, we had created these two processors, and when I started this processor, it created a flow file. Okay, so I'm going to start it and stop it again, and if you see, if it has queued one flow file. So basically, whatever a single piece of data which we have is called a flow file, and also each flow file is going to have three attributes: unique ID, file name, and path. So the way to check that is if I click on this view details, and if I go to attributes, you will notice that each of the flow files are having mandatory these three attributes. Okay, you can have any number of attributes defined, but these are the mandatory attributes for flow files. Next common terminology which we are going to use is processor. So basically, any individual component which you see here on the canvas is called a processor. A processor is going to perform some action, and it is also going to listen for incoming data. So in this case, generate flow file and log message, these are processors. So relationship, what is a relationship? Whenever we connect a processor to another processor, in this case, as you can see, I have connected generate file processor to log message processor. So these are going to connect using a relationship, and that relationship will be different for each processor. So if I right click on this processor and I select configure, you will be noticing that in the settings section, we have something called relationship, and under that, success is defined. Okay, so that's why when I connect this processor to this processor, log message processor, I see only success as a relationship. However, there are processor which has more than one relationships. For example, let's take an example of adding a detect duplicate processor. Okay, so the way to add a processor is by clicking on this processor component and then dragging and dropping it here on the canvas. And then in the filter, you can search the process group by the name. So I'm going to use detect duplicate processor and then click on add. So now if I right click on this processor and click on configure, then you will notice this processor is having three relationships. So whenever I connect this processor with any other processor, I need to define all these processor relationships. So you may have, so for example, in this connection, I can define as duplicate relationship. So all the data which is duplicate will be going to this processor. And then let's say we want to define or we want to connect non-duplicate data to some other processor, so we can do that way. I'm just going to do Control C and Control V to copy and paste log message processor again, and then I'm going to connect detect duplicate to log message, and all the failure and non-duplicate let's say I want to send it to this processor. So this is how basically you define a processor and relationship. Just remember, each processor has different type of relationships. So what is a connection? A connection, basically whenever I'm connecting one processor to another processor, we are going to have kind of connection. That's what is basically called a connection. Next one is controller services, which is also a very common terminology in NiFi. A controller service is something like which controls a common configurations. For example, in case of connecting to database, it can be our JDBC or ODBC connection details. This is just one example. We'll be discussing in more detail about these controllers in next sections. After that, the next most common terminology is process group. So a process group is basically a way to organize your flows or your processor. So here, if you see in this section, I do not have any ability to create directories and subdirectories. So I cannot organize my flow. So let's say if I right click here, I do not see any option to create a directory and inside that define my coding or processors. As you can understand, from a development point of view, it is going to be a very big pain if I have to create hundreds of processors on the same screen. So process groups makes it easy and gives us a way to organize our processors and a common functionality. So what we are going to do is, I'm just going to drag it towards right, and here in the empty canvas I'm going to select process group and drop it here. And let's say this process group, I name it fetch files from source, and then I can double click on this. Just notice here on the left side, left bottom side, that right now you see NiFi flow. So we are at the root of this canvas. So once I double click on this, I'm going to go inside that process group. Now I can have any number of processors defined in this process group. So basically I can have something like generate flow file. I can have something like fetch file. So you know, all these processors are part of this process group, and I can have any number of process groups. I can have process groups inside process groups. So for example, if I go inside this process group, I can create another process group, okay, which will, let's say, contain file validation related processes. So if I go inside this, I can define my code or logic to validate a file. So this is a good way to organize your data and also your codes, basically, not the data, the metadata. Port, so we can skip port section for now, we'll be discussing it later. The most important one is bulletin. So bulletin, if you just see here on the right side, we have something like a bulletin section. So whenever any error is coming, that errors are going to displayed here in the bulletin section. And other than that, we have this very important file, which is called flow.xml.gz. So if you also notice, whenever I drag and drop any processor on the canvas, I do not have any ability to save anything. So how you basically save your development work in NiFi? So the answer is, you do not need to save anything. Whenever you actually make any changes here on this canvas, it automatically, instantaneously saves that change in this flow.xml.gz file. Okay, and also I will tell you the location of this file. So if you remember, we have installed the software here on this machine, and we are inside NiFi admin home directory. And if I do ls-lrt, I'm going to get NiFi directory detail. So inside this, if you see, we have something called conf directory, and inside this, if you see, we have something called flow.xml.gz. Okay, this is the file. Whatever changes you make here goes inside that file, and you do not have to take any action. This is taken care by NiFi. And also, let's say if this file is deleted, and you might be thinking that you are going to lose your data, so that is not the case. All this file is periodically being archived into the archive directory. So if you go inside this archive directory and do ls-lrt, you will see all these flow files has been archived. So whenever you make any changes, the previous change goes inside this archive folder. So this is a very good thing to know from an admin point of view. Now let's discuss about NiFi user interface. Okay, so as you know, NiFi URL is basically going to be the URL which is specified here. And in the hostname, you need to give the IP of the machine or the hostname on which you have installed NiFi. So now when you install NiFi, you'll be seeing something like this. So the top bar is called Components Toolbar, and on the right side we have Global Menu, and below that we have Status Bar. On the right side we have Search button, and next to that we have Bulletin. And on the left side, if you see, we have Operate and Navigate Palette. So that's it. It is very simple interface, but it is still very powerful. So now remaining things we'll be discussing about when we actually start going into more details, and also we'll be discussing all these things when we are doing hands-on exercises. So that's it in this video. Stay tuned for next videos.